Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I want to look at performance when it comes to hierarchies. If you're using a hierarchy, you may want to pay attention to this. Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, hierarchies. Hierarchies can be used for a lot of different reasons. Maybe it's an organizational structure. Maybe it's a product structure. It's a parent-child relationship of some kind. I had a customer scenario come up where they were using this parent-child hierarchy and they were taking advantage of some of the DAX functions to make this easier to work with. What happened though is when we tried to implement RLS over that, we hit some performance problems. Let's dig into that aspect of it and see if we can make it go a little faster. So enough of all this talking, you know how we like to do it on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. I've got a matrix with our hierarchy that's listed, and then we've just got some measures over here that are calculating what's actually going on. The data itself and the results here aren't necessarily interesting. What's interesting is we have the hierarchy structure and we've got data in place to go and test this. So what we want to do is always, let's get our baseline first so we know what we're working with. So we know we're going to be hitting some performance problem when we introduce row level security. So what does it look like without row level security? And then we can measure what that performance difference is. So let's just go through the tools and the approach that we teach here on Guy in a Cube. You do this a bunch of times, you become masters at it. We're going to need to start up our friend performance analyzer. Let me minimize these guys so we can see what's going on. The other thing we're going to do is we're going to start up DAX Studio. Now I've already got a DAX Studio set up. Honestly, I've already got the item in here, but what we would do is once DAX Studio is up, let's clear the cache. So we're clearing the data cache and then we'll come back, start recording. A lot of folks I see, they want to hit this refresh visuals, which will refresh all the visuals on the page. In this case, we just care about the matrix. So I can hover over here and you'll see this icon to analyze this visual. This icon only comes up when you've started recording in Performance Analyzer. This lets me just refresh this specific visual. And then we'll go and copy query. So this is the query. I've added some headers here so we can keep track of which one's which. So let's go ahead and clear cache and run. And then this is our baseline, right? 20 milliseconds, 12 storage engine queries. Looks good. The majority of the time here is in the formula engine. For this particular example, I'm not going to pay attention to that. I'm really focused on the total time and the total storage engine queries. So we can see these storage engine queries listed here. Okay, so now we've got our baseline. What is it with RLS? So let's just go real quick. And let me also show the data here because I said this is a normal hierarchy. So here we've got our path column and it's just got the path items listed here, right? So this is our parent child hierarchy structure for the depth of what those items are. I've also got these items listed out in individual columns. These are all using the path DAX functions that are available inside. So path item, path length to generate this data. So let's go look at our row level security. Here, we're just doing path contains. We're saying, look, over that path column, which is the hierarchy structure, is this ID included in the path structure? In the customer's case, they were actually using dynamic row level security for handling certain items, but I just wanted to simplify this to actually show just a straight RLS, we can hit the same thing. The challenge here is this path contains. Path itself is a string, and we're doing string operations over this column. So whenever we work with strings, there's a chance for a performance issue because it takes a little longer to do that as opposed to working with integers. So I've got an item here. Option one is our RLS rule. It's the same DAX query. What I've done is we're connected to this role. So this connection is going to apply the role level security that's defined. So this is going to use the path contains. Go back. Let's clear the cache on the main one because I can't clear cache when I'm using RLS. And then let's run it. Our baseline was 20 milliseconds. With using path contains, it's 73 milliseconds. 73 milliseconds is still fast. Why are we even talking about this? Hang on. So let me introduce another option here. Instead of using path contains, which is using string operations, what if we just did a simple filter? So in this case, these items are all integer columns. And if I know what that item number is, why can't I just do a straight compare on those columns with that number? So just a simple filter as opposed to doing a string operation. Yes, there's more columns here, but let's see what actually happens. Make sure it looks good. We'll save it. This is our option two. Actually, let me go ahead and bring these back up so we can see everything. And let's go ahead and connect and we'll do option two. Start server timings. We got to come back to our main one. Clear the cache. Let's see what we get. 38 milliseconds. Wow. So the simple filter is definitely faster than doing the path contains. And if you're working with smaller sets of data, in this case, this is 100,000 rows, you may not care. So if you're doing this across multiple things, let's say we've got 7-8 visuals in there, it adds up, right? So you want to be mindful about how things are performing. The other thing here is test and compare what works faster, what works slower. So yes, 100,000 rows, still under 100 milliseconds. Let's crank this up a little bit. What if we had 1 million rows? Maybe that's out of the realm of possibility for what you could think of for a hierarchy, but maybe it's realistic. Let's see what happens. This is my 1 million row data set. So it's the same visual. The query is still the same. So let's go back to our main item here. I'm going to connect to our 1 million row database, start server timings, and let's get our baseline, right? So we're going to clear cache and run 27 milliseconds. 100,000 was 20 milliseconds. 1 million is 27 milliseconds. That's pretty good. Let's do our option one. So let's reconnect to our million row database, start our server timings, clear the cache, and then let's see what this does. Wow. Over 2 seconds to run that operation using path contains. Let's see what the option two does. Let's reconnect. 1 million, option two, start server timings, clear cache, and run. Whoo, 92 milliseconds, still under 100 milliseconds using the simple filter. That's bananas. It's really important that you test things and try different alternatives. So obviously we want to use the simple filter here versus path contains. That's a no-brainer. All right, I want to throw this back to you. Are you using path contains to do hierarchy operations? Have you tried using simple filters instead to see if that helps? Yes, it could blow up the model, but it could make your DAX way faster. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.